In this video, I show you the very best Audacity settings to use when you're starting a new project. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. And today, we're looking at the best settings to starting a new project in Audacity. There are six settings that you want to check when you're starting your Audacity project. And these are the project rate, audio drivers, microphone, recording type, playback settings, and your recording levels. Once you have all of those things set, then you're ready to start on your project. So let's go over them one by one. The first is your project rate or your sample rate. This is found in the very bottom left-hand corner of the default layout. And effectively, the higher project rate, the higher quality of audio you're going to produce. The higher the number that you use, the more disk space this will take up on your hard drive. The standard rate is 44,100, and that's the equivalent to the quality of a CD that you would buy in a shop. I recommend this for everybody starting out. However, if you're finding it's not working for you as you start working on your project, then you can always increase it or decrease it as you wish. The next option is setting your audio drivers. There are three drivers for me. You may have more depending on your computer setup, but these are the three standard ones you would expect to see on a Windows computer. The MME is the oldest and most reliable type. It's got the most flexibility in the audio driver. And the Wasabi driver is best for very low latency. If this doesn't mean much to you, then I would recommend using the MME, and that's what I'll be using for the remainder of this project. Now, if you're going to record audio, when you click this button, it will start recording, and it's going to pick up from the device that you select here. In most cases, if you're podcasting, you'd want it to be your microphone, but depending on what devices you have connected, means you may have other options down here as well. As you can see, I've got my webcam, the software that I use to mimic having a mixing desk, my standard microphone, my USB microphone, and the input, which is currently empty on my computer from my sound card. You will have a different set of options here, and you need to select the one that works best for you. Now, if we go over to the recording type, you've got two options. You've got mono or stereo. Most microphones will record in mono. However, if you have very specific setups, you may also be able to record in stereo. Now, this does depend on your own personal preference, so it's worth testing it out. But stereo will mean it comes out of both sides of your earphones or headset or speakers, whereas mono means it will come out of one. With the stereo option, you can also pan from left to right and make more audio effects later on. So for simplicity, click mono, or for more functionality and flexibility, click stereo. Now we come over to the playback device. Again, this will depend on what you've got plugged into your computer. I run everything through VoiceMeter myself, but it's probably likely that you would want to select your USB device, which might be your headset, or your speakers, which would be plugged in to your computer. And lastly, before you start recording or start doing anything, you want to make sure the audio levels are correct when you start recording. So if you come up here and you click, this will show you the monitor. Now, what you don't want to happen is for this bar to go above zero or hit the maximum. As you can see, it does spike up quite high on mine, but the general area is between 12 and 18. And when I'm not speaking, it goes down to minus 36 or around that area. There are two ways to adjust this. The first one is over here, and the second way is through the PC or the hardware if it's got a volume control. Now, it doesn't matter how you adjust these, but what is important is that the top marker, this blue line, doesn't hit zero. It can get close to it, like with me, and it can sit around the 18 to 12 mark usually. That's great, but if it exceeds zero, what that's going to mean is you will lose quality of your audio. Okay, so if you're all happy with that, then I personally think that this can get distracting as you're recording. So I click mine off which is exactly why it's there. You can turn it on or off, but just make sure that when you've got it on and you're looking at it, that you have all these settings set up before you start recording. And now that you've looked over all of those settings, you can safely start the rest of your project knowing that everything is set up correctly. I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.